Hi guys, welcome back. This is a little Neotech preview of some of the new things I have coming up because I think they are pretty cool and I wanted to share them with you. First of all, I want to just get this little tiny thing out of the way. I was actually recently working with logistic pipes and I saw that they have a little selector for the slots they're pulling out of and I really liked it. So I'm not going to say I copied it because I didn't copy their code or anything, but I was inspired by what they did, and so now our pipes will iterate through the inventory in a connected line of items. That's subtly different from how it was before. It would always do the first available, and B shows this neat little icon that shows you which one it's currently identifying. So that's a small little change, and I do realize this is pretty much exactly what Logistics Pipes does, but again, the point of our mod is to bring together the best of all the mods in 1.7 and put them all together to make a great tech mod, and this is just an example of that. Anyway, on to something totally different, the sun system. You can see these items here. I'll go ahead and point out these items are not how you're going to create the suns. This is just A, for my debugging purposes, and B, giving them an item form should I ever decide to go back and forth. There's no crafting recipe, there's no way to make these at the moment, so don't think this is how we're going to go about it. To create a star, you're actually going to create this item. So I lied. This item you can create. It's the inert sun. This is your sort of stepping stone into the late game power generation. It will be essentially some very condensed stone. I'm not sure exactly how I'm going to go about crafting that, but it will be relatively difficult to get. So at that point, you know, we'll see where we are at that point, but now you have this little tiny sphere. As you can see, it's using the stone texture as its texture on the sphere, and it's pretty small. Let me see if I can get a block behind it just to give you guys an idea. It's maybe, you know, 4 pixels across if you were to add it all together. This one might be a little better. Oh no, it's actually inside of it. Anyway, that's this little guy, and this will be what you start with. It doesn't do anything. It doesn't generate power. It just sort of floats there. It's not going to hurt you if you go near it. You can walk all around it. You'll be fine. The stars will burn you, by the way, so be careful of that. But you will feed this hydrogen and maybe some other resources, but at the moment, this is the only one I can think of. So we do have two new gases, hydrogen and oxygen, and I only added oxygen because I needed hydrogen, so we'll find a use for this, I promise. If you have any suggestions, please let me know, because I don't know. So to get hydrogen, it's pretty simple. We already had a nice little machine for doing this. Let's stick some water in there, get hydrogen and oxygen. Couldn't be much simpler than that. Now that you've got the hydrogen, which I'll point out, we updated our renderers to handle gaseous stuff, so if you put any gas in our tanks, they will be upside down, just for fun. So once you have that, there'll be some sort of plasma disperser, whatever I'm gonna call it, that will feed this guy here the energy and the resources it needs to become a blue dwarf. So I'm gonna get rid of him, and now we have the blue dwarf. This is the very first sun that will be created. It is a little bit different from the other suns because it does not have a natural decay. So once you've energized a sun, it won't turn back into an inert star, but it will go down to this point. The blue dwarf is the smallest the sun will become, and it does have a natural decay on the larger ones, so be aware of that. The blue dwarf does generate passive power. There will be a way to harness it. Yes, I could use solar panels, but I'm not going to do that. There'll probably be some sort of a machine that you set around it, and it will pull energy out of it. And the more machines you put, obviously, the more power you can pull out per tick. But it does not generate as much as the other suns. It generates, there's a 200 per tick base, and then it takes in account the radius multiplied by a base value. I'm not going to go too deep into that, but just to point out, the base value for this is like 15 or 20, and the base value for the other stars is like 200. So there's a significant jump when you get this to a small sun status. So speaking of, now we have the small sun. Once you get it to this point, and that's just enough to be off the ground, I didn't have to jump. Once you get to this point, that is where active generation comes in. This will consume its resources. It itself contains the energy that it needs to continue its reactions. So the blue dwarf, yeah, it would eventually burn out. And I might give it a super long lifetime where if you're not feeding it, it will eventually go back to the base, inert star. I'm not sure if I'm going to do that yet, but I probably will. But this will be the base, and these guys will be your real bread and butter of the generation. So as you can see, this guy's slowly shrinking. You probably can't see now, but I'll leave him going while I go over the rest of it, and maybe we'll see him turn into a blue dwarf. But this is the small sun, you can see here. It generates more power. The bigger they get, the more power they generate. That's pretty much it. Here is a large sun. I'm actually going to fly in the air for this one because it's a little bit bigger. This is a large sun. It is the next tier. It's a darker orange. That one's kind of a yellow. And again, more power, bigger thing. It's going to be harder to maintain. There will be increased instability with larger stars. You'll need some sort of item or machine, moreover, that will stabilize it. Or you need to manage your feeding and draining of it. If you're giving it more energy than you're draining, so with the hydrogen disperser or whatever, that's probably what I'm going to name it because I keep referencing it. But if you're giving it too much, it's going to inflate too quickly, and that will add to the instability. And if you're draining too quick and you're not giving it anything, that will also add to the instability. And the bigger the instability, the more likely it is to either A, probably explode very large, so be very careful, or B, condense into a black hole if it's a red giant. Now the red giant, I'm going to go ahead and show you what he looks like. He's a little bit bigger, and of course he is red, and I'm not set on the radiuses of these yet. They will actually probably be even bigger. So maybe I can get some blocks up here to give you a sense of scale, because I know it's kind of hard to do when they're floating in the air and you don't have anything to go against. But, you know, that's sort of an idea. Get a few more blocks just to give you a better sense. Maybe you can count them if you really, really want. But that's sort of an idea on how big they are. Maybe 5 or 10 blocks. I believe this one has a radius of 5, so that would make it a diameter of 10. It is a straight block size. So this guy, the red giant, wherever he went, oh, I accidentally punched him, that's what happened. The red giant, if he collapses, can possibly become a black hole. And that might actually be good for you, because the black hole somehow, again, I have no idea how I'm going to do this yet, I just wanted to show you guys that it's up and running, and there's going to be stuff coming very soon. But there will be a way to link two black holes together to create tesseracts, in all simplicity. They will create a wormhole between the two. It's probably most likely that there will be some sort of machine or tool that will harvest a black hole into an item, and that will allow you to put it into a frame that will link two places, and maybe you'll name it in an anvil or something, or we'll do some sort of other indicator to give it a frequency that the two interact on. Not sure how I'm going to do it yet. But when you do that, you'll have your teleportation between two points. As you can see here, this original guy has gotten pretty small, and he's almost down to the blue dwarf size. Now, there will be a way to move these guys. I'm not sure how I'm going to do it yet. I keep saying that a lot because I really don't know. This is kind of a crazy idea I had, and I'm just doing it step by step. More likely, there will probably be some machine you put down, and it pulls stars towards it onto the block above it, and then that's just what you're going to be stuck with. I've thought about the idea of having stars merge when they collide with each other, but At the moment, I'm not going to do that because I had it implemented, and the more I thought about it, the more I thought there's a slight potential that it could be abused because the inert sun starts with a default radius, and that's technically a free amount of energy that you put into it, and then by combining two stars, you get the equivalent of both of those free energies added together. So I'm not sure I'm going to do that. I might change the energy to not be based off the radius, but the radius right now is pretty much the main number that these guys use. I don't know. I wish I had more answers for you guys, but I don't know, and that's why if you have suggestions on this system, please leave them, because I do need help figuring this out, and I've talked to Dionovan and some others to sort of plan this out, but we still haven't gotten to the stage where I can really flesh stuff out, so please go to the forums. You can post in YouTube, I don't care. Just find a way to give me some information so that I can think about it while I'm going further into this. And you can see right there, this just turned into a blue dwarf. There might be a slightly fancier transition between the two, but at the moment it's pretty stark. So yeah, that is the suns. It is the start of what will be a new sort of section of Neotech. Again, with the whole system of teleporting stuff, an idea that we did have was when you create a black hole, it will suck everything into it, like a black hole will, so it's kind of like a trash can if you really wanted to have a trash can. But if you throw an interface pipe into the black hole will break, and the pipe will get transformed into a tesseract-type pipe. And anything that goes into that pipe will get put into that network that you can interface with. That's probably where I'm going to go with it, because I think that's kind of neat. But I'm not sure yet if that's where I'm going to go with it. Again, if you have any suggestions on that, or any suggestions on how I should be doing it, feel free to let me know. I know this is departing a little bit from what a traditional tech mod would be, but that's kind of what we want to do. We've gotten to the point where we have added a lot of the stuff that a tech mod should. A lot of the things here, just basic ore processing. We did something a little bit different with our metals. Some basic machines, and yes, I'm going to do more farms, I promise. But I wanted to get power generation because I felt that was the most lacking part of the mod. We also have pipes, decorative, tools, metals. You know, we have all these things, and the tools, again, are not done either. They've started, and I took the things I found most important so that I could hold people off while I work on some other aspects. But essentially, the mod's really big, and I'm just one guy. Dionovan's just one guy. Even with the two of us working on it, there's a lot to do. So bear with us as we continue. And as always, giving us feedback is really helpful, because that actually has influenced a lot of how this mod has gone. I know with some of the recent drama about mods not wanting to go to 1.8, and now that 1.9's almost out, people are going to move to that, and you know, the modding scene needs a tech mod. And that's where we're at. We're not trying to replace them. If they update, that's great. We want to work well with them even. We'd be willing to do that. But we want to provide our take on what a tech mod should be, coming from the experience of using all of the old tech mods and bringing them all together into a new idea. Again, this is sort of a... that's the idea of Neotech. It's to be a new take on it. You know, everyone's trying to do a tech mod, but we want to be a new way to do it. So please give us feedback. The star system is kind of crazy, and I don't know what I'm going to do with it in the end. I know that you're going to harness power from these suns, but I don't know exactly how you're going to feed them and how you're going to... well, I know how you're going to harness power. They'll just be a machine. But a lot of the specifics aren't rounded out. So I'm going to stop rambling, and I'm going to end this video. And again, one final time, post on the forums. That's the best place. You can do the comments here. I get it pinged my phone, but I don't like their interface for interacting with people as much as I do the forums. There's my Twitter if you really want to get to me quickly. And of course, we always have our IRC channel. Feel free to jump in there. It's Neotech. Clearly, that's a simple name. We're always in there. You can always chat with us. We've had a few people come in and give us some ideas. We've worked with some of the other devs in there. So feel free to hop in there to give us suggestions. And I'll see you either in the next video where I spotlight this or in another video where I give you another progress update. So hopefully it'll be the first one and not the second, because I want to get this done relatively soon. All right, thank you guys for watching. Goodbye.